part four of our Mad T-shirt series, we're going to be focusing on instruments of all kinds. We're going to be thinking about the way that instruments are divided up into families, strings, woodwind, brass, and percussion, depending on how the sound is produced on each instrument. This diagram shows how an orchestra is laid out, with the strings at the front shown in red, the woodwind behind in yellow, the brass behind them in green, and the percussion at the back in purple. We're not just going to be looking at orchestral instruments though, we'll be thinking about instruments that are used in all styles. Stringed instruments are easy to understand. They're the ones where the actual sound is produced by a string being plucked or played with a bow. Here are the orchestral stringed instruments: violin, viola, cello, and bass, ranging from the smallest to the largest. As with all instruments, the bigger the instrument, the lower the pitch of the sound. The strings were traditionally made from something called catgut, which was never actually made with the intestines of cats, but is actually made from sheep intestine, which has been dried and twisted. Nowadays, strings for instruments are still sometimes made from gut, but often from nylon or steel. You'll remember from the video on articulation that the word for plucking a stringed instrument is pizzicato, and the word for playing with a bow is arco. Stringed instruments are used all over the world. There are all kinds of plucked and bowed instruments used in lots of different styles of music. Some of the ones you'll be familiar with are guitar, ukulele, banjo, and harp. But there are many other stringed instruments in all shapes and sizes. Any instrument that needs air passing through it to make sound is a wind instrument. Wind instruments come in two distinct types. We're going to look at woodwind instruments first. These are the four basic woodwind instruments that you would find in the orchestra: the clarinet, the flute, the oboe, and the bassoon. The clarinet, oboe, and bassoon all have reeds. The flute doesn't. You make the sound by blowing air across the hole in the mouthpiece, a bit like when you make a sound by blowing across the top of a bottle. Modern flutes are mostly made of metal, but historically they were made from wood. Often, extra woodwind instruments are used in orchestral music to give a wider range of pitches and timbres. The small version of the flute plays an octave higher and is called a piccolo, which literally means small in Italian. The cor anglais is like an oboe, but a little bigger, so it plays lower notes. Notice the bulge in its shape at the bottom and the curved crook at the top end. This is how the cor anglais got its name. It literally means English horn, but there's actually nothing English about it at all. The name is a corruption of the word anglais, meaning angled, referring to the crook that the reed goes in. The bigger version of the bassoon is the contrabassoon, which plays super deep notes. The bass clarinet is, as its name suggests, the big version of a clarinet. Sometimes people get confused about what kind of instruments saxophones are. Saxophones come in different sizes. These are the four most common kinds. Although they're made of metal, they're actually woodwind instruments. This is because they have a reed, which is very similar to a clarinet reed. So the sound is actually produced by the vibrations of the reed. That is what makes it a woodwind instrument. Don't make the common mistake of thinking that a saxophone must be a brass instrument. It isn't. There are lots of different woodwind instruments used in all kinds of music all over the world. Some are like flutes or recorders, some have reeds, and they come in all sorts of shapes and sizes. Remember, what makes an instrument part of the woodwind family is having a reed or a mouthpiece similar to a recorder's, or making the sound by blowing across a hole as you do with a flute or piccolo. There are some woodwind instruments that you don't actually blow into, but still use air and a reed to make their sound. On the right here, you can see the reeds that are inside an accordion. There are actually several different reeds for each note. Instead of blowing into it, the air is moved across the reeds by pushing and pulling. The concertina part of the instrument is called the bellows. The melodica is a keyboard instrument that you blow into. Inside it is a reed for each note. The church organ is a lot bigger, and of course you don't blow into it, but each note has several sets of pipes, all of which are powered by air from a big set of bellows. All of the different sounds on an organ are created by different kinds of pipes. Some work a bit like a recorder, but others have reeds. You can combine the different sets of pipes using the stops, which are the buttons to the sides of the keyboards, so that each keyboard, including the pedal board that you play with your feet, has a different sound. The organ is definitely the largest woodwind instrument. Brass instruments come in different shapes and sizes, but are all played in the same way. These are the brass instruments that are commonly used in an orchestra, ranging from the trumpet, which is the highest, down to the tuba, which is the lowest. The brass section sits near the back of the orchestra because they can play very loud, and most brass players very much enjoy making a lot of noise. What makes a brass instrument different from a woodwind instrument is the way that the sound is produced. You don't just blow into it, you have to buzz your lips into the mouthpiece. The buzzing on its own sounds like this. The different pitches that you can hear are made by tightening or loosening the buzz of your lips. There are lots of different kinds of brass instruments other than the orchestral ones. This diagram shows several of them and how they are related to the orchestral brass instruments. You'll see some of these instruments in brass bands and marching bands. All of them have cup-shaped mouthpieces that you buzz your lips into. There are lots of different types of percussion instruments. These are the ones that you hit, shake, or scrape to play. They can be tuned, like the xylophone and glockenspiel, which means they have different notes, A, B, C, D, and so on, and can play melodies. Others, like the tambourine, cymbals, snare drum, bass drum, and triangle, are unpitched, so can play rhythms, but not melodies. The timpani are an unusual example of a drum that is tuned to actual pitches and is often used to reinforce the bass line of the music. Percussion instruments come in a huge variety of types and are used in all kinds of music all over the world. This diagram shows just a few. Some are pitched, but a lot are unpitched. They're made from lots of different materials, but in all of them, the sound is produced by hitting it, shaking it, or scraping it. Although the piano has strings, it is not really a stringed instrument, as the strings are not plucked or played with a bow. Inside the piano, the strings are hit with hammers when you press down the keys. It is this hammer action that makes the piano a percussion instrument. In a rock band, you have percussion instruments, the drum kit, and stringed instruments, the electric guitar and bass guitar. With the electric guitar and bass, the vibrations from the strings are amplified through a pickup, which then sends an electrical signal to the amplifier. Keyboard instruments in rock and pop might include a piano, in which case it's likely to be mic'd up to make it louder, or an electronic keyboard. There are lots of instruments where the sound is not made by strings or air going through a mouthpiece, but is electronically generated. And electronic instruments come in lots of different sizes and shapes. Some have a keyboard and others do not. Some use sampling to make their sound. This is when a recording of an existing sound is manipulated by the instrument to make something new, or even something that sounds a lot like the instrument that was recorded to make the sample in the first place. Some use synthesis, which is when you create a sound from scratch using electronics or digital technology. A lot of pop music nowadays uses electronic instruments or a combination of computer-generated sounds and acoustic or amplified instruments. So how can you tell what kind of instrument you're listening to? Sometimes identifying what you're listening to can be tricky, but you can use your knowledge to help you. Think about the style of the music. If it's classical music or film music that's played by an orchestra, you know the different kinds of instruments that are likely to be found there and will be able to tell whether they are strings, woodwind, brass or percussion. Listen for whether the instruments are high or low, how the sound is being produced, and for the timbre, that's the individual sound of the instrument. Watching videos of an orchestra playing or seeing an orchestra playing live can help you begin to make the connections between the instruments and their individual timbres. If it's rock or pop music, listen for whether it's using the traditional rock lineup of electric guitar, bass and drums, or whether electronic sounds have been added, or indeed whether all of the sounds have been created electronically. Try to listen actively to every piece of music that you hear, and see if you can work out what is playing.